brought to you by Penguin.
Release the Beast, a drag queen's guide to life. Written and read by me, Bimini Bon Boulash. Introduction, not a joke, just a fact. Bimini Bon book author, you better bloody believe it, babes. If you've got this and you've started listening, you probably already know who I am. Or maybe you're just a pervert with a hots for the bad bitch on the cover. You might have sat front row at one of my drag performances at the Glory in the early days, or watched me being crowned Missing the Pink, or more likely, you saw me strutting down the catwalk on RuPaul's Drag Race Season 2, dressed as a slutty Norwich City football player, in a suit covered in acne, or in the guise of an amoeba. Never say I don't have range. This book is an absolute don't wake me if I'm dreaming moment for me. I realised after being on a mainstream TV show that it was crucial for me to use my new platform to speak up and shine light on topics and political issues that were really important to me, both inside and outside of the LGBTQ plus community. Now, here I am, a couple of months later, with a book deal from Penguin Books, pinch me, and the incredible opportunity to write something that I wish I'd had my hands on growing up as a confused, gender non-conforming, queer kid in a small English seaside town. Self-help books don't usually cater for people like me. They're usually written with a certain reader in mind, and that reader ain't queer, non-binary, or working class. They're also very prescriptive. Stick to this diet, order your pants drawing this way, fit into this book, and people will love you. I've written this book as an antidote to all that. Think of it as an anti-self-help book, a radical and affirming self-love manifesto based on 10 transformative life lessons that I have learned through the art of drag. My aim with this book is to encourage the celebration of nonconformity in all of its senses, to give you the confidence to flip order and convention on their heads in your own life and teach you how to live outside of society's definition of normal, whatever the fuck that is. Ultimately, if you feel like you don't fit in, this book has been written to empower you and encourage you to always be kind to yourself, no matter what. So that's why I wrote it, in the hope that this book opens up the minds of readers across the gender spectrum, inspires kindness, and helps any queers out there, young and old, who are struggling with their identity. Drag gave me the confidence to get up on stage, perform, and do the things that I'd always dreamed of doing. It was an empowering gateway into the exploration of my own gender identity. Hopefully, the valuable lessons I have learned from drag over the years will help everyone listening to or reading this book to live the life they want to lead, no matter who they are. Nothing is out of reach. After coming out as non-binary on TV in an open and light-hearted conversation with UK drag legend Ginny Lemon about gender and non-conformity, I was overwhelmed and inspired by the support and kindness in the responses online and in the media. Topics like this very rarely receive any kind of thoughtful coverage in the mainstream media. We had managed to break through the system just a little bit and shatter some of the misconceptions about being non-binary and gender non-conforming, and even inspired some people to come out to their friends and family. Incredible. Release the Beast is my way of sharing the joy, power, and strength that is to be found in not conforming, in the broader sense possible. The life-changing magic of dragging up is very real, and it's for everyone. In what follows, I share stories from my own life and personal struggles with gender and identity, as well as the stories of many of the wonderful nonconformist, convention-breaking icons that have inspired and helped to create the Bimini Bon Boulash that you see on this cover. From fellow drag queens and kings to musicians, gender theorists, fashion designers, and more. These 10 lessons will guide you through everything I've learned from my experience of drag and applied to my own life, from how to embrace the femme, dismantle the patriarchy and be a system offender, to the importance of knowing your herstory, how to navigate the world of fashion and fitness as an outsider, how to develop a positive mental attitude and, most importantly, how to love yourself, he, she or them. Class is in session. When you finish listening, I hope you come away with the confidence to be your authentic self, to challenge nonsensical norms and binaries, to not conform, to celebrate difference, and to live outside of society's bizarre boxes. It's okay to mess up. We're all human, and we're definitely not all perfect. Take it from me, the best art comes from fucking up, learning to laugh at yourself, and going against the grain. We'll all get there, eventually. So to all the nonconformists, gender benders and system offenders out there, to anyone listening to this book who feels like they don't fit in, this is for you. It's time to release the beast. Someone do a death drop or something. Oh, nice. Life lesson one, don't be scared to embrace the femme. The idea of drag fascinated me from the moment I first saw it. I viewed it as an expression and celebration of femininity or masculinity for drag kings, although the two aren't mutually exclusive. I'll be explaining more about all of this later on. Which wasn't something I had been able to celebrate in my previous life without feeling shame or guilt. There was an intrinsic confidence that I longed for. Perhaps naively, I saw all the good in drag immediately and ignored the issues with some parts of the drag world that shouldn't be ignored. Like the fact that some forms of drag can be misogynistic. Something I hope to tackle head-on in this book. But back then, when the 18-year-old queer kid who knew deep down that a strict gender binary didn't resonate with my own experience, saw drag as a gateway to the exploration of my own gender identity. Despite being labelled a boy when I was born, I was always drawn to femininity. My earliest memories all have women playing the starring roles. If my early life were a movie, men were the mere extras while women took the lead, the supporting roles, and were directing and producing too. Women ran shit in the world I grew up in. My babysitter and her daughter, my mum's best friend's children, my friends at playgroup, my mother, my grandmother, my auntie, the list could go on. I was always around female energy. I was also what you might call an attention seeker. I remember getting Remy, my mum's friend's daughter, to cover me head to toe in gloss paint while I paraded around completely nude like I was an art installation at the V&A. Our mums found it hilarious, although they did tell us both off so that we wouldn't do it again. We wasted an entire pot making my skin glow like I'd just been on a photo shoot in Hunger magazine. I think people warmed to the idea that I was an attention seeker very early on. It was cute because I was young, but as I got older, I became more socially aware, knowing that expressing femininity as a boy would earn me ridicule. One of the things I would do was create a rota at playgroup so that I could get my way of being in charge of who wore the pearl necklace and the dress that day. I was not only an attention seeker, but a boss bitch from a young age. Nobody could tell me what I was doing was wrong. Although my mum tells me the playgroup staff found themselves immersed in controversy when parents would come to pick up their children and be outraged at Tommy, aged 3, looking drop-dead gorgeous in a purple velvet dress. My mum always supported the idea, thankfully, because it obviously made me happy. That's what parents ultimately want, right? A smile on their child's face. When you're young and you're developing, your environment is a key factor, but I think it's important to not look for reasons why a child is gender non-conforming. Looking for a reason suggests there's something wrong. Some kids just are, and that's fine. My mum has also had a huge influence on my understanding of femininity, as well as strength and resilience. When I was very young, she was a single mother, working her arse off to provide a better life for me. I grew up with a mum who was an incredibly independent woman. She didn't want to ever have to rely on a man because she knew she could rely on herself. Her work ethic is unparalleled, and as I grew up, I understood this. I'm eternally thankful for what she sacrificed to provide for me, and even better, she'd be doing it all in a heel. I always viewed my mum as glam, gorgeous, and a go-getter. She's the strongest person I know, male, female, or somewhere in between. Femininity can be powerful. I walked into season 2 of RuPaul.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.